Hi, I'm with Luke from Holding Absence.
Hello, good to meet you.
Luke?
Yeah, not too bad, thank you.
He played already.
Yeah, we did. So
tell us how it was.
Yeah, really good. Like, it's one of those things. You Download Festival is such a fairy tale experience for every band, and you know, we've been looking towards it. It's been like the finish line for a long time for us now, and like yeah, it's just surreal to kind of finally get to. We were on the Dogtooth stage, so yeah, it was sick. It was perfect for us. Like, I'd hate to be put on like a too big a stage and then be like, oh, but yeah, it was really cool. And like, it was very surreal because it was like the finish line that we've kind of been waiting for quite a long time now. So yeah,
can't
happy days.
Help but notice your T-shirt. You're a Cure.
Yes,
fan.
I am. You know, I am.
Young to be a Cure fan.
Yeah, well, my parents are big on music. Oh, like, they got me into the Pixies, the Cure, Joy Division, all the good stuff. So like, I think it's really important to show that you are quite like, you have an eclectic taste in music, I guess, and we're inspired by everything as well. Yeah, totally. Yeah. So, good shirt as well, so can't complain.
So how would you describe your own music then?
It's tough. Like, on a sonic level, we fluctuate very often. Like, there's a lot of soundscapes and atmospherics and stuff, but at the same time, we can be quite a heavy band. Like, so it really does jump back and forth. But I guess our message is that we're quite a sincere, honest band. Like, our music is very much true to us, and like, I think that, regardless of the sonic kind of qualities, that is the point of our music, really. So,
somebody who's never heard you before, what would be the go-to song to hear you in?
We've only got two songs out, if you can believe that. So it really does depend. Like, we wrote them both to kind of contrast one another. So we got a song called Permanent, which is a lot, I guess, for the Download audience. Like, Permanent is heavier. It's a lot more like upbeat. So that would be a good choice. But we've got a song called Dream of Me as well, and that's done really well on Kerrang, like TV, radio, and stuff. So it's more of like a radio single, I guess. But yeah, they both encompass who we are as a band. So.
You planning to record some more, an album?
Yeah, well, we've got a new single coming out in just over a week, I think. So we haven't really announced it yet, but yeah. We're working towards an album, though. Like, for us, that is the goal. Like, to do, if we were to do an EP, we'd feel like we'd sell ourselves short a little bit as well, because, you know, we'd love to be able to write like a huge body of work. So,
you signed?
Yes, we are. We were Sharpton Records in America.
Soon,
so yeah. we're super excited. Yeah.
Excellent. So you're on tour now then?
Not at this particular moment in time. We tour very often. Like, if a show comes in, we'll translate it into five shows. You know, I mean, we'll do three before, two after, or whatever. Like, so we did played Swansea two nights ago, just kind of get ourselves nice and warm for Download. But yeah, we're just, to be honest, this is the first time we've had a show and not to be like early nights, you know, because we got a gig tomorrow, you know what I mean? So like, it's quite a nice experience for us to just be able to have a couple of beers and just like chill out, man. Yeah, watch some of our favorite bands and just really soak up the atmosphere of being in a band.
Did
you
come to see anybody in particular? You want to see anybody in particular?
Like I said, individually and personally as well, we have so many different, like, I don't know, favorite bands and stuff. Like, between Devin Townsend and Code Orange, 2 million miles apart bands, like two huge inspirations for us. And I could talk all day about the brilliant bands playing this weekend.
Did you check them out earlier?
Code Orange.
Yep.
Yeah, of course we did. They are savage, man. They are such a silly band. Brilliant band. So yeah.
And then tonight you're gonna see
System of a Down got me and our bassist James into just like distorted guitars, I guess, and like, and appreciating that like music doesn't have to be boring, you know what I mean? Like, that's the best thing about our band. Like, I don't care how many drugs they took to write the music, like the music is so unique and particular, and it really inspired us growing up. So
fantastic. So when you're on tour or when you're doing gigs together, do you share a tour bus or you share
we love slogging out in like the same little van and stuff. Yeah. I think like, I'd hate to feel disassociated from each other, you know what I mean? I'd hate to turn up to a show and be like, hey, you know, good to see you, how's your day been? You know what I mean? Like, it's great to wake up and go to sleep with the same group of people and really experience.
Friends.
Yeah, we're the best of friends. Like, yeah.
So when you're on a bus, is there a messy person in your band?
Oh, they're yeah.
You can name and shame now, because
to be fair... he's over there as well, so I can't name his name. To be fair, though, we aren't the cleanest band in the world. Like, not the way... I think there's a difference between messy and dirty. That's a big thing. I keep telling my mum that as well. I'm not a dirty person, I'm a messy person. So the pants on the floor, not a bad thing, it's just a messy thing, you know what I mean? But yeah, our van, you know, everybody in bands knows how it is. Like, your van is never going to stay clean, so
no.
You just need to embrace it a little bit. So.
But you don't care about that stuff when you're on
not
tour.
At all, no, you don't. So.
You enjoy touring? Or you prefer recording?
Great question, because we are in in our kind of scene and our kind of like genre of music and stuff, like gigging is so important, and we gig so often you'd be fooled into thinking that it is the be all and end all for us. And despite the fact that it really does kind of get us out of bed every morning knowing that we've got shows coming up, like a big thing about our band is that we are very, very music driven. It's more about the music we play than the gigs we play, you know what I mean? And that's a super important thing. So when we get to like the recording process, it's a different world to playing gigs, but it's still equally as important. So yeah.
So if you were to go on tour with just one band, your favourite band, or for all of you, would you say there's a band that you'd all like to tour with, or just for you personally?
Our music tastes differ hugely, really? So there could be a million bands we'd love to tour with. I think...
Who would suit the band?
On that, I'd say between Deftones and Thrice, I think.
Another Deftones, that's...
I think everybody just wants to watch Deftones as much as they can. Whoever said it earlier just wanted to watch them for a whole tour, which is the main reason I said that then.
Like
so,
So. What about a band that's dead? Any bands in the past that you'd like to tour with before they passed, obviously?
It's funny because we've had quite... Because like, I feel like typically we're a post-hardcore band, but we take a lot of different elements. So like, you look at Alexis on Fire, Thrice, Under Oath, they were all long gone for quite a long period of time. They've all just come back, so maybe I would have said one of those bands, but... That's a really good question. Sadly, I don't have a particularly good answer for it, but we're big.
You bet your bunk now and think about that
one. Yeah, I will, and it'll click, and I'll be like, no, why didn't I say it? Personally, I'm a big fan of like 90s post-hardcore, like bands like Fugazi would be a great. Fugazi. Not that the rest of the band would agree with me on that, but a band like Fugazi, a band like The Cure, like
but
you said.
Got the mic, so you pick.
There you go. Yeah, you're going to have to tell them that, though.
So we got one challenge for you, Luke. See that little jar there?
Yep.
It's a sour challenge.
Yeah, I'm good with sour sweets. But
okay,
how many?
Okay.
Is it just one?
You put that in your mouth.
Yeah, is it
and then
really
announce
bad?
Announce your name on your bag.
Ah, there we go. Lovely. Okay,
see
cool.
How long it stays in your mouth.
I just
don't
lost your pen
that.
As well.
We've had a few people 1 second only. So
oh, really?
I'll show you the one if you like sour.
I've had loads of vocal. You know vocal zones? The yes, yeah, I've had loads of those today as well. So my tongue is just like sore
you'll
today.
Fine.
I think the problem is having a sweet in your mouth. Hello, this is Lucas from Holden Absence. Yeah, is that cool?
Very good.
Lovely job, thank you. These are killer. I'm going to finish this as well.
They're pretty sour, aren't they?
Fuck it.
It'll get better as you go. I promise
you. I hope so.
You'll get some sweet stuff eventually. And you like sour, you see.
Not as much as I did.
Not as much as
2 minutes ago.
Yep. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Cheers.
Enjoy the rest of Downloads.
Oh. Shouldn't have held on to this.